Not really. I mean, football is a journey, and every year it's got its own challenges and its own inspirations. If you look at how many times we've missed the leagues and at how many points, I mean, 1 point at some season, sometimes it's 2 points, and sometimes it's 1 point, 3 points. So we've always been there, and we've always got trophies in between. Just that the league has always eluded us, and this time it came around. Fortunately, I mean, everything went with God's blessings. Fortunately, things were very good. I mean, the honors the chairman got throughout the year. If you look at Stuart coming back and the consistency we had from day one to the end, but we've always kept a trophy in the cabinet. And in my history, being part of the club, I've won the league also twice. I mean, I've won the Mandela Cup. As a leader, you'll always get the betting when things don't go right. When things go right, other people get the glory. It's normal. It's part of the business. But I'm not an ambitious person. I'm not excited. For me, it's more about getting those supporters, getting the club and the players enjoying what they're enjoying. Like now, for instance, the players are enjoying themselves, the coaches, everybody's getting the accolades, which is good. It's what I want to see. It's about the organization, the supporters being happy. That's my job. That's the passion I have. My job starts now again because I've got to look at the coaches going on leave. Everybody, the players are going on leave. Who must stay behind and start cleaning up? It's me again. So I must make sure that we obviously, you know, put the puzzles together. Obviously, the coach has his needs, but I've got to make sure that we put the puzzle together. And it's not only me. I mean, it takes agents, it takes clubs to come to the party. It takes, you know, the chairman to come to the party as well in terms of making sure that we agree that this is the direction we need to take. Obviously, the coach has his needs, and we have to make sure that organization sustains. So it's going to take a lot again once more. It's going to take agents, it's going to take clubs to agree, it's going to take the blessings of God once more. We had a big shopping list in the past season, which I want to thank the clubs once more that came to the party to allow us, although it was a big spending spree. But now we have to have additions, which sometimes it's about the balance of the development and also what positions are really need that we need to bolster. We're not going to be going on a big shopping spree because, you know, if you get top stars coming in again and they're not playing and you've got your own players who are not playing, it creates a problem as well. It creates a bit of a challenge for you get people sulking, you get players who are not playing who've been regular in their teams. So we need to create a balance, and that's the challenge that we faced with. I need to sit, work around that, and make sure that when the coach comes back, I give him options and say, these are the options that I have, and these are the options that I've... Like, for instance, Stuart came here, he found the team solid as it is. So I've got the same challenge again to make sure that, you know, he comes back again and finds a balance. But you must remember as well, if I get a regular player from a top team, whether it's a central defender or a striker, I must make sure that he's coming into play. And if I get a youngster, it must be a youngster that understands that he's an understudy, but at the same time, he's got an ambition to play and to make a mark. So that balance is a bit of a challenge. It takes a bit of a sober mind and a bit of time again to really do a proper calculation. Not really, striker. We had a meeting with the coach today, and we're having another meeting with him tomorrow. And I think we're going to be looking at backups. I mean, we've bought players this past season. We're going to look at backups. If you're going to Africa in January, you can't buy in January because you have to give players coming in to adapt to the system. So, like I say, my job starts now again, once more. I don't go on leave when people are going on leave. So we'll make announcements later in terms of what we've decided and what we've put together for the coach. And he must also, you know, support it and be part of it like he did when he came. We've not made any announcements yet if there are any players going. The only problem we have is the injuries that we've incurred this season. That's why we need to make sure we create that balance again to make sure that, you know, the players that were injured come back, and we also have a backup for them, because we don't know some of these injuries, they recur, and some of them, you know, they can heal and be 100%. So we've got those challenges. Going, we've not issued a list because, like I say, I have a final meeting with the coach tomorrow. So if anybody goes, it's not because he's a bad player. It's because sometimes we need them to play. Some players didn't play this whole season. Some players played one or two games. But as a football organization, we need to allow players to express themselves. Some we might loan to make sure that they get that practice and that experience of playing. Not that because they're bad, but I think it's a reality. We can't keep on having people who are not sitting on the stands every day, and some sulk, some doesn't give a good spirit in the team. So we need to rotate a bit where we need to rotate, and we need to support where we need to support. I need to create a balance in terms of the team. I've got players who have not been regulars in striking positions. I've got players in that role that he plays at the moment, and he's a top player in his club. If he comes to Chiefs, is he prepared to sit and wait for an opportunity, or he wants to come in and command a position? And we really need him in the team. For me, I don't think so. And I wish all these speculations and rumors and everything should stop, and let's allow people to do their business properly. I'm going to come up with a plan, and we'll make those announcements as and when they come up, and they will announce the type of players or targeted players that we need. At the moment, like I said, I've got a meeting tomorrow with the coach and they will, with the chairman, and we'll finalize in terms of the needs of the coach. But I don't think it will be wise for us to take a player that is a top player in his club and comes here. I've got a Majoro, I've got Parker, I've got Kingston, I've got even Stembe Songoba is on the stands. So it's a bit of a challenge. Kaiser Junior is not even playing at the moment. So we need to take stock and make sure whoever that we bring, we make sure that he's got a position there or is a backup to the system that we have. We have not made a shopping list. We've not went out to... I think we had a plan with Stuart when he came, which is the reserve league. There are players that I'm going to look at in that aspect, where Ace was given a task to develop certain players for preparing them for this situation now. So we're going to start off there first and make sure that we bring those players on board and make it... If there's something exceptional than what we have there that we've been building, then we'll look at it. That's another position. Jimmy's been a regular. He's been a captain. He was a captain in the Chiefs. He's been a regular. He had a serious injury, and he's not getting younger. At the same time, he's got competition now in his position. He's got Power, who's been commanding a regular position. He's got a Moleko, who's a backup. Now, if he comes in, is he patient also to wait for his chance to come? If he's patient, it's up to the coach. It comes back to the coach. If the coach says, I want to have this type of player sitting, waiting for their turn, he's not getting younger. He's aging, and it's meetings that I'm going to have with perhaps the likes of Jimmy to sit and look at the future and say, what does he think, how does he feel, and what the coach also feels. Josta is officially in contract. He's going to be extended one more season. His contract will be extended one more season. We've agreed in terms of keeping him with the coach, so he's definitely in the team. Bartman definitely is retired. Obviously, I've got two young keepers behind him now, and we also have another young one which we're looking at. So there'll be four keepers. So definitely, we're looking at a situation where how do we integrate him in the development with the goalkeeper coaching department to see how we can maybe he can plow back his experience in the youth. But definitely, he's not in the books for playing next season.